What's up, family? What's up, boys and girls? It's me, Skeet Jones, on my Positive Nation TV and podcast. Skeet got so much stuff going, he can't even keep up with it no more. This TV and podcast, I guess. But anyway, I'm happy to be here. My very special guest, my very beautiful, special, talented entrepreneur guest is here, Nikki Bird. Give her a hand, y'all. Thank you, y'all.
Hello.
Thank you, Nikki Bird, for spending some time. I got a chance to sit back and watch you and Paula G chop it up a little bit. Now, I know Paula G got awards and everybody know her, but you talking to Skeet now.
Hello, Skeet Jones. I'm so excited to be here with you.
Thank you so much. Now, I asked all the questions that the boys and girls want, you know, because they want the blueprint to success. That's what I'm all about, the blueprint. Now, Nikki Bray, in 5 minutes, tell us, what is the blueprint to success? What was the road that you took? How did you become an entrepreneur? How you become an engineer? How you become a loving wife and mother? The little kids want to know now so they don't make those mistakes. They want to know this so they can get out of school and do the right thing. They don't want to make no mistakes. They don't want to take that hard road, the road of hard knocks. We don't want to do that.
Yes. So first of all, I would say, trust in yourself. Trust in who you are. And don't ever think that you don't have enough inside of you to be whatever it is you want to be. Because most of us, when we look back to our childhood, that is where we find what we are really passionate about. So I want you to think about what it is that you love doing. Like, you can do it in your sleep because you just love it so much. And then expand on those things, because that is where your passion lies. And so get educated, because you cannot do anything if you can't read or write, and you can't be a millionaire if you can't count money. So you want to make sure you do excellent in math and science and history and reading and writing. And once you do that, you can do anything. Wow. Because you're going to follow your passion, your dreams. You're not going to be lazy. You're going to trust your instinct. Does anybody know what instinct is? That's that feeling that you get when this feels great, or this doesn't feel quite right. Follow those and you will be successful in whatever you choose in life.
Wow. Nikki, bro, you said something really, really important in your presentation. And that, when you name all of those subjects, you know, sometimes the boys and girls just don't understand, why am I taking earth science? Why am I taking English writing? I don't like to write. You know, they don't understand, you know, that it all plugs in together so they can become successful. Now, real quick, tell us why it's so important that the boys and girls learn how to write proper English and speak.
Yes. So this is just a foundation for you to be successful in whatever you choose, because you have to know how to write checks. You have to know how to write contracts when you do business. You have to know how to write to make sure somebody else is not taking advantage of you. So if you can't read what's going on, you can be taken advantage of. So you need writing and reading, like, over everything else, because then you just build on that. So I know it may not be fun and it may seem hard, but if you just learn a little bit at a time and build on that, it won't be hard at all. And stay on top of it. Because most of the time, if you be honest, it's only hard because you've gotten behind on your homework, or you've missed classes, or you're sleeping in class, or you're not paying attention. And now you have to play catch up. And now it seems hard. So stay on top of it and you will breeze right through.
Now, Nikki, bro, you look like you could have been a bookworm. Now, did you play in elementary, middle school, high school, college? You know, was it a, you know, did you go up and down, or when did the light bulb go off?
So listen, I'm going to be very honest. I have always had to really study. I was not that person that made all straight A's, that made all A's and B's. I made occasional C's sometimes. And my parents, you know, were not happy about that, but I felt like I was doing the best that I could. I was an athlete. I played sports. I played volleyball, basketball, ran track. And, you know, I was a singer. So I was doing a lot of different things, and I probably could have put more effort and spent more time, but I felt like I was really, really well-rounded. But I always had to study, always. Even in college, I got an engineering degree in mechanical engineering, and I had to work for it. I had to study, and there were days where I said, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm going to change my major. And then everything in me said, don't do it. You can do it. If you made it this far, you can finish it. So don't quit.
Right, that was the devil trying to put that doubt in your mind.
Yes.
Yeah, what was your boyfriend was trying to tell you that? We ain't gonna go there, boys and girls, but
yes, no.
Sound like you were talking a lot about focus, staying busy, you know, doing your homework. You didn't have time to be messing up, right? Was that what it, that's the whole trick? That's the
blue. That's exactly right, Skeet. That's exactly right. No time for foolishness.
Skeet can go kind of deep sometimes, you know. I surprise myself when I go back and look. This was that me. That was me. But anyway, Nikki Bryant, now I was on your page and I saw that you had a sachet, like you was running for some type of pageant or some
sort. So I was crowned at the Rhythm of Gospel Music Awards. I was crowned the 2019-2020 Miss Nigma, and that's for National and Independent Gospel Music Association. So I got a chance to actually be crowned queen and really encourage and inspire young people all over this world. So through Facebook and Instagram and YouTube and in person, I've been able to have lock-ins with young girls to just talk about life, to talk about, you know, the challenges that kids go through, because sometimes I think as adults, we think, oh, the kids don't have any problems. They don't have any real issues. Just because it's not bills or, you know, all of those things, you know, young people really have issues that they are facing, bullying and, you know, just friends and drama, and these things can really take a toll. And so I have been able to use this platform to reach out to young girls to encourage them that they are queens, that it's not about the outside, it's about the inside. It's about how you treat yourself first and how you treat others and then how you allow people to treat you.
That's right, that's right.
Yeah.
It is so important what you just said about the bullying. Now parents, this reminds the parents that sometimes you have to sit down with your kids just because they
not
calls from the police or the principal or the teacher means something. Mm-hmm. Right or wrong, you need to sit down with them and say, hey, you know, you're not their best friend, but you still want to be there and let them know you're there to make sure they are successful.
So that's true, Skeet.
What's going on? They ask them, hey, is any, how's the things going to school? Is anybody picking on you? Is the teacher being respectful? Because sometimes
right.
A lot of them took the job not because they want to be a teacher, but because they want to be a bully or they need to pay their bills.
Skeet,
Skeet just being real.
Right. That's right.
I know I can get on this soapbox forever because I'm defending, I'm an advocate for the kids. I speak for them because it does take a puppet to raise a child. I'm being honest.
Yes. We always have to be open.
Right. And I feel your purpose. I'm finding my purpose. And you made it real clear what my purpose is. I should be on TV all the time.
Yes!
Skeet a comedian. He's funny. But anyway, I just want to remind Jerry Voice mom who's watching this that my name is not Skeeter. My name is Skeet Jones. All right, Nikki Bright. Okay, 3 seconds, 30 seconds till they get some people some encouragement because I'm encouraged. I'm pumped.
Yes. So listen, today is your day. Forget about yesterday. Forget about all of the things that didn't go how you thought they should. Forget about all of the things that hurt your feelings, that got you down. Today is a new day. And today is your day to move forward in your purpose and your destiny and your dreams. Today is your day that you take back who you are with force and move forward in this life with everything within you. Be positive. Be positive. Keep a smile on your face and just be a light.
That's right.
Be a light. No negative words, no negative thoughts, and no negative actions. And take this day by storm. You will never be the same.
All right, Nikki Bragger, one last question. Skeet just wonder, are you Jamaican? Because you got a lot of jobs.
I'm not. But listen, what I'm learning is when you do what you love, you never have to work a job again. Hey. You're just waking up every day, walking in your passion and your purpose, and you can be doing 10 different things, but you don't feel overwhelmed and you don't feel stressed out because they're what you are supposed to be doing.
Yeah, I feel it. All right. Well, this has been a segment of my TV show, my podcast with Nikki Bari. I'm Skeet Jones Podcast. Take care, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Take care, little kids. And remember, it takes a puppet to raise a child. Take care, everybody. Peace out.